Alaska Live TV. Music and conversation from the KUAC FM studio is made possible by a grant from Design Alaska. Architecture and engineering for the new frontier.
Great to have Thought Trade here at the Alaska Live studios. I'm your Alaska Live host, Lori Neufeld. Thanks for coming here, you guys.
It's great to be here.
Thank you.
What are you kicking off the show with?
We're going to start a song called Photogenetics.
All right. This is Thought Trade on KUAC's Alaska Live.
The years you put
Yeah, that is the sound of Thought Trade on Alaska Live. Wow, that was really kind of funky and psychedelic, and I liked it a lot. That song is on your newest CD called Recapitation, and it was called Photogenics.
Photogenetics,
yes.
It's actually called Recapitated, like decapitated, but putting your head back on.
Oh, did I get it completely wrong?
No, it's totally cool.
It's a made-up word.
When you make up words.
Yeah. It actually took us about 4 hours to come up with that one day. It was an interesting day in the garage.
The name of the album is Recapitated, like the opposite or the deconstruction of decapitating, the reconstruction. It's kind of a freaky title in a way.
Yeah, well, I don't know. We were trying to think of a word that captured everything that was kind of going on in all the songs, and I don't know, that just seemed kind of...
a lot of time.
Yeah, it's like getting a new mindset almost.
Yeah. Yeah, it's more hopeful. I mean, you've been decapitated, wandering around without your head, and now it's back.
But you have new insight into things you never really knew even existed before.
Right. I like that. Oh, man. I've got this new microphone in the studio. We got a wireless mic, so the drummer is no longer cut off from the conversation. Travis Burrows, you've been here on Alaska Live before, and you're no longer cut off from the conversation because I've got a wireless mic, and just sit back there and you can pick it up when you want. And
I was wondering if I was going to be off the hook for this, but yeah,
no.
I guess I have to talk.
No.
But that's okay.
You know, your excuse has always been, now I'm stuck here back by the drums, and there's no microphone that's close enough, and I'm not going to shout at the mic. So I'm really glad that we... have you on now, not just your drumming. Thanks for dropping off this CD. Well, I think I came and picked it up at the coffee shop one day. And thanks for getting this to us, because it has just some wide variety of tracks on it. It's really cool.
Thanks. Thank you.
And yeah, so, I mean, we're pretty proud of it. We worked really hard on it. And it's the first CD that we did that was really a true, like, track-by-track studio album, because previously we've done like recording in a room with just basically stereo tracks, no mixing, no mastering, hope it sounds good kind of a thing. And so it was definitely a different and interesting process to go through.
Cool.
Months of mixing.
I know. I heard. That was a great song to start off with. It's called Photogenetics. Awesome. A hard time, because I don't know if I heard that word in the song. Was that word in
no.
the song?
Well, so we couldn't settle on a name, but we always kind of just make up, you know, what's the a word in the song that, you know, like, oh, remember this song by saying, oh, photo or something. So there's picture frame in the song several times. So
gotcha. Excellent.
That's the roots.
Awesome. Are you ready to go for another?
Absolutely.
You've changed around a bit. Danny, now you're on bass, and Patrick, now you've grabbed the guitar, and gosh, I didn't even see it happen.
We're practiced.
Yeah. We're really nervous.
Aw, don't be nervous.
Just Danny.
You're just on the radio. You'll be on TV eventually. All right, it's Thought Trade on Alaska Live. Do you know the name of this song?
Yes, absolutely. This song is called Double Happiness.
Cool.
Thank you.
That's so hypnotic what you've got going there. I mean, that's great.
What just happened?
Right?
Where are we?
It's trance-inducing. I can see that you could have put yourself into a trance, Danny. Has that always been a goal for you in songwriting, is to get some of those trance-like songs together?
The rhythms. It's all about the rhythms. We like to mix it up and make, Danny or Travis over there drum his little heart out. So
I think our first goal as songwriters was to just play songs, anything we could play. Like, we didn't know what we were doing. And, I mean, I've said that before when people have asked me. And, like, we've come so far. And, I mean, it's really interesting to see, like, what we've made. And just with our outside influences, what, like, our likes.
Would you say that you were more focused on instrumentals when you first started out? Or were you always...
Oh, absolutely, yeah. Okay. We didn't sing at all. And we actually never even... thought we were going to play in front of anyone, and then it just started happening. And
really, you were a band before you ever started playing out or even thought you were going to?
Yeah. You might want to get in on that, because he knows the full history. We'll be here all night if we need history.
Well, I do know that Aaron Wool, who's not part of the band right now because he's off at school, right?
Right. Yeah.
He plays keyboards.
He's just not here.
Oh, okay.
He couldn't be here because he's at school.
Right. So he's, of course, he's not kicked out of the band or anything crazy like that. No. Of course not. Where does he go to school now?
He's over in Worcester, Massachusetts, going to grad school for electrical engineering, doing something.
And he used to be a volunteer here at KUAC,
right.
And he had a late night show, around midnight show, like on a Friday night,
right?
And it was called the
Mycelium Network.
Mycelium Network, and you guys would come in after his show and do some practicing, right?
Yeah, it kind of started out where I think. Well, Pat says that Aram started talking to me, but I thought Aram started talking to Pat. They did the show together.
No, he was talking to you, and I heard you guys were going to make music, and I was like, I got to get in on that. I want a part of that.
So we, actually would go into the what's now like the music library.
Right, it used to be kind of like the extra studio. And
yeah, just Aram would have his keyboard, and Pat had his 12-string acoustic guitar, and I had a drum set, and we literally have our first practice recorded.
Nice.
Which we will not share, but
those were some fun late Friday nights, I bet.
Oh yeah.
Well, it's so cool that you're back here now and on Alaska Live. It's
yeah,
so
this is
appropriate.
Awesome. An honor.
Nice. Yeah,
really glad to be on here.
Nice. And so, what year was that? Do you even?
2005. It was like late July, and it was actually just the three of us for a couple of months, and then we got Danny in on it. We
just, they already had me.
We just brought him. And then it's like maybe 6 months later, we had Casey come on to play bass because we didn't have a bass player.
Right.
And they said, we weren't even planning to play live ever. We didn't play live until, I think, like June 2007 about. Which is probably a good idea because we were pretty untalented with our instruments. Just making weird instrumental music.
It's so good to, clean it all up and make it sound good and to get there onto the stage after you've done that. If it takes you 2 years, whatever, you know?
Oh, yeah. It maybe should have waited longer, but, we've gotten there.
In the beginning, it was just complete pure collaboration. We would just start out and be playing, and then all of a sudden something would happen, and we would just go with it, and just eventually we would just name it, and that would be a song, and... A lot of them are just recorded, and we couldn't really reproduce them, but we try.
Yeah.
And then when we started actually recording like real albums, we had to really buckle down and become more, focused and like craft the compositions more. I mean, these songs didn't really happen by accident, I guess.
Yeah. So it seems like a very collaborative effort. For
Absolutely.
Thought
Train. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Everybody's got a part in it.
Yeah, and everybody has like almost an equal voice, or like basically, yes, an equal voice. It's really cool. It's really a special thing to be a part of, actually.
It is really cool. You hear around the room and you look around the room and you're all playing. There's not a lot of solos going on necessarily. It's all kind of parts, at once and parts at once. Kind of like a symphony almost, arranged like that. Like a symphony orchestra. Well, when you throw a cello in there, it starts sounding, like you've got even more layers of arrangements on top of that. Sabi, how did you become part of Thought Trade?
I don't really know. How did I become Travis?
I met Sabi last summer playing with a mutual friend, Isaac Paris, mm-hmm. doing some shows, and I started playing some of her songs, and that was really fun. And then you were out of town on and off for a long time, and when we were recording this album, I got the idea that, like, we should, you know, even Casey thought of it too, that we should get Sabi to play on one of the tracks because it'd be really cool to have a cello on there.
Oh, yeah, it's the thing to do these days.
And she came up with that part, and it just, sounds great. I don't hear that song anymore without that part in my head. Like, when we play live without that, it's just kind of like, where's the cello?
Well, Sabi, you can't go on tour with them.
Sure, I'll go.
But so when we were getting ready to do this, we were going to be without Aram, and our songs kind of were. I felt, you know, just like that extra layer, gluing sound together. And it was just kind of like, wow, maybe Sabi would want to play with us and randomly learn 7 other songs besides the main one. And then, she did it. And it really sounds good.
Wow. Sabi, you had to learn all kind of extra songs in the midst?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, no problem.
Yeah, it's fun. These guys are hilarious. I've never practiced with a band like this. They're very amusing.
Cool. Is it? It's not the norm for you to play with a plugged-in band, right?
Oh, I have before.
You have. Okay. Yeah. Cool. Because I know you were here with your trio, which was named
The Extra Toughs.
The Extra Toughs. Exactly.
Yeah.
Cool.
Yeah, and that was more acoustic.
Yeah.
Except for Emily's keyboard.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Well, should we feature the cello in another Thought Trade song?
Absolutely.
All right.
Thank you.
What's the name of that song?
A Taxi Attic.
Is that a name you made up? Is that a word you made
up? Actually, Pat knows the definition for that one.
A taxi is like the inability to control your body.
Okay.
It's like spasms, random spasms.
Uh-huh. And
that's why it's in five. Yeah. It's hard to dance to.
Yeah, you do confuse the dancers on that one, I'm sure. And what about the name Thought Trade? That has to be a name of another band. It's a really good name. But I looked it up, and you're the only Thought Trade. And I don't say that sarcastically. I think it's a really good name for a band.
Well, Aram actually came up with the name.
Aram came up with the name?
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
And after going through several names, thinking about it forever, kind of like naming the album, we just kind of heard that, and we're like, yeah, okay. He showed us a picture of the sketch of these two people with these large heads, kind of like a couple, like leaning together, so their brains were like melding and their arms were intertwined like serpents. And we're like, oh, okay, yeah, that's great, actually.
That's right. Oh, we got another changing. Danny and Patrick are changing places again. Oh, no, it's the trio of you switching now. That is...
It's called the dance.
It's the trading of the thoughts. No, it's really the trading of the instruments is what happens. That's one of the gifts you guys have. You can all play, you know, either electric guitar or bass, right?
Yes.
That's very good, very good. And Casey, were you always part of the band?
I was, yeah.
Okay.
I mean, officially, I guess, yeah, mm-hmm, from mm-hmm. the beginning.
Mm-hmm.
I started playing bass and then... I actually played guitar originally, but they asked me to play bass, so I did, and then it evolved from there.
Right, they decided, we need a bass player, too.
Yeah, just to kind of glue it together.
It's hard to be a rock band without a bass player.
Yeah, even a psychedelic band, you need a bass player.
But it's easy to be weird with instruments.
Yeah. Yes, Danny, it is easy to be weird.
For you, right?
One of these days, you'll switch out the cello player, too. Whoa.
The
cello
and the drums.
No.
Thank you.
look down. No, I'll play my cards right. It's a stick around. My predictions just won't count. If we get defensive, we can shovel
No predictions.
No predictions. All right.
It's a love song, kind
of. Is it the one love song on the album?
You know, yes. they're never happy. They're always about something sad. So,
of course, of course.
But it is a happy one.
I like it that you're featuring all songs off of the newest, latest album that you have. Is it still available for people to pick up?
Yeah. Or there's actually, I think, copies at College Coffee House, Gulliver's Books, or you can just shoot us an email at thoughttrade@gmail.com and just get in touch with us that way. But it's also available on digitally on thoughttrade.wordpress.com. You can listen to the whole thing for free, mm-hmm. and our previous album, Fallow, for free as well.
Right. And so you can pick it up in town. That's very cool. I like to hear that. Who did the artwork for it?
My friend Adam Otavi.
I thought it was Adam. Is it one of those
Ambrotype photography?
The Ambrotype photography. Yeah, that is very cool. And whose head is it? Is it yours?
That's Ian
Patrick.
Okay, so
that's his scalp.
And shoulder on the back.
And
it looks freaky on the back too. I mean to tell you, I don't know. Is there something piercing his skin on the back?
I think it's just the photograph is peeling or something.
Yeah. Yeah, that's just that old style photography that just makes it look weird and cool and antique. Well, very nice. Way to go. Way to put out a second album that you can be very proud of. And I know that you did it over at Sunnyside Productions, James Bartlett's
Shout
studio.
James.
I know.
He's the sixth member.
Me.
He really is. He's been recording us since the beginning, since our first recording, Escape Validity, which we put out in 2008, just instrumental.
Mm-hmm.
Just the stereo tracks in the room at his house, and just kind of evolved with us. You know, he's when we recorded Fallow, we did that. That was sort of a track by track, but we did that kind of live in the Empress Theater when he was working on doing sound and stuff for The Tempest.
Mm-hmm.
So we were inside this big wooden boat set, and we did it like on a Monday. Had to move our cars every hour, and I think Danny had the flu.
Because it was downtown, you know.
I could barely stand up.
One day we could do it. Yeah. Nightmare recording session.
Recapitated just came out so amazing. I mean, just his skills have just grown immensely mm-hmm. and quickly, and the equipment he has available to him now, we ended up using, initially we recorded onto like a Porta studio, a Boss Porta studio, and during the time when we were recording, he got a hold of a new laptop and Pro Tools, and he just learned it like instantly.
Yeah. I think his first project was Alaska Live Volume 5.
Oh, yeah.
He was like, I'm getting it in the mail. It'll be okay. And it was.
It's going to be all right.
Yeah, he's got a shiny disposition, so Sunnyside Productions. All right. Do you have another one in you? Another couple, at least.
I have three more ready. Oh, but
very good. Do it.
This is actually from album Fallow before Recapitated.
All right.
It's the last track. It's called Lock Position.
Is that too loud?
No, you're never really too loud.
Never?
No, I don't think
tell
so.
Them that.
Every day.
Let's just try this.
In here.
Thank you.
Danny, do you play more like up on the neck of the guitar when you don't have Aram on the keyboards, or is that something you do just the moment?
That's just like a thing I saw once that I thought was cool, so I tried to do it. And
do you remember what guitarist you saw doing it?
There's a lot that do it. We just call it tapping. It's just,
Instead of strumming, you're tapping.
Yeah, it's like using the instrument as a percussive instrument instead of like just a stringed instrument that you pluck.
More like what a piano would do, hit it with a hammer. Yeah, cool. And I was surprised that that song from your older CD had vocals too, because that one didn't have as many tracks with vocals on it, right?
Right. Well, actually, I think there was only one that didn't have vocals.
Oh, on Fallows, there was just one that didn't?
Yeah, just one, Keep It Straight as Possible.
Okay, gotcha.
But there was, you know, vocals were still evolving, I think, in that album.
Yeah, I think so.
And we developed it more, Danny.
And we had like four previous releases before Fallow came out, so.
You had some practice.
We've been working for a long time
Yeah. All right, what's next?
A song called Misconception. It's off of Fallow. It's a darker song than the other happier ones.
But we'll end with a happy one.
Oh, sure.
I promise.
Thank you.
Oh, I like the song's dark. I like that one a lot. What was the line in there? Something about peace on earth. You weren't around peace on earth. What was that line, Casey?
Yeah, I don't know. I can never remember in the middle of it.
Right, I'm sure.
Basically,
from
yeah, awake from peace on earth.
Right. Yeah. I was like,
yeah.
Oh.
You know, just reflect on the bad things that happen and write a song about it.
Right.
Feel better.
It almost felt like at times it was from outer space reflecting on the world, you know.
Yeah.
Because it's dark out there in outer space, I've heard.
Yeah.
I've seen pictures. Yeah.
Well, unless you're looking at the Earth and then it can be blue.
Right. Wow, this has been so fun. Well worth the wait. I know we've been planning for a long time. Travis, it was in the works for so long. Yes, let's do Alaska Live with Thought Trade.
Glad it worked out, I mean.
And you like measured it out, and what'd you say? You even threw down tape at your practice space?
Yeah, Pat, set up blue masking tape, and like before we came here today, we set up as if we were in this room, and it was like, oh, it'll fit. Okay, good.
Totally worth it.
I'm a builder, so I have to measure everything.
Right.
Measure everything.
You came in looking very official on Monday, too.
Yeah, I was wearing my goofy vest, my safety vest. I always forget to take it off when I get off work.
It's okay.
Makes me look like a real champ.
You were being safe wherever you went. Well, Thought Trade, it's been so great to have you here. Do you have one more song?
Absolutely.
All right.
Count us in, Travis.
Trade is Danny Opgenorth and Casey Smith, guitars and bass and vocals, and Patrick Malou, bass and electric guitars, Travis Burrows, drums, and Sabi Flores plays cello. Thanks, you guys.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. This was awesome. Thank you very much.
You can find full episodes of Alaska Live TV and download audio podcasts of the Alaska Live radio show online at KUAC.org. Alaska Live TV. Music and conversation from the KUAC FM studio is made possible by a grant from Design Alaska. Architecture and engineering for the new frontier.